Now that we've explored how ISO folders appear in Windows, let's shift our focus to the ISO interface itself and examine the available options for creating our drawings. In the Chapter 10 project, there's no need to open any files just yet. Instead, we'll take a guided tour of the interface. To get started, navigate to the ribbon menu. Right next to the Home tab, you'll find the ISO tab. Click on it, and you'll see a range of options for generating ISOs. A key distinction to note here is between a quick ISO and a production ISO. When working within an intelligent 3D modeling environment, every isometric drawing created is typically linked to the project. During model development, ISOs are often generated at various stages to review layout, identify breakpoints, and ensure clarity by avoiding excessive congestion. However, generating multiple test ISOs can clutter the project database with unnecessary links. To manage this, Plant 3D offers two choices. Quick ISO. This allows you to generate an isometric drawing for review, but it is stored in a separate location and isn't officially registered within the project. Once your final IFCIs are created, you can simply delete the temporary folder without needing to remove database links. Production ISO. When a production ISO is created, it is formally registered within the project. For example, if a pipeline, such as line 100, undergoes finalization, the resulting drawings are systematically stored under the corresponding project section. Another option available is PCF to ISO conversion. A PCF file is a system-generated text file that captures model data and translates it in isometric drawing. This method enables interoperability between different CAD platforms, such as Bentley or CADWorks, allowing PCF files from external sources to be converted into Isometrics without needing the original models. Moving on, the ISO Annotations tab plays a vital role in enhancing drawings. When developing models, repeatable annotations help maintain consistency. For instance, if a pipe passes through a floor grating, manually adding this detail to every ISO would be time-consuming. Instead, adding it directly to the model ensures that the annotation automatically appears on every generated isometric drawing. ISO annotations allow for various notations, including reference dimensions, fabrication messages, floor penetration symbols, insulation indicators, and location markers. These elements help fabricators interpret drawings accurately. Additionally, the start point and break point functions assist in controlling how isometric drawings are generated. We'll explore these features in greater detail later. For now, this serves as a general overview of the interface and its capabilities. As we progress through this chapter, we'll apply these tools in practical scenarios to deepen our understanding.